Okay, so in this video we're going to look at chain rule. So this is the process of differentiation where you may have more complicated functions to differentiate, and so you have to apply chain rule. So we're going to go through this bit by bit. Looking at page 25 of your log tables, here is where you have lots of information about differentiating certain functions, okay? So what we're going to look at is these ones here and how to differentiate them using chain rule when you have things that are more complicated. So taking the first one, we know already that when you have something to a power, it differentiates to bringing down the power, taking one away from the power, and that's what we get. So we bring down the power and take one away from the power. That is our basic differentiation process when you have something to a power. So chain rule kicks in when you have something more complicated than just an x. Okay? So in this case then, when you have something more complicated than just an x raised to a power. And the way you do that then is you will bring down the power as you would have done before. Whatever that is being raised to the power goes here. You take one away from the power and then you multiply by the differential of whatever that was here. Okay, so I always use this visual, this kind of box method, and I find it super, super easy to follow. So the shaded box is always the differential of the plain box, if you like, okay? So let's take an example. And let's say you had 4x plus 2 all to the power of 5. So straight away you see you've got something more complicated than just an x being raised to a 5. So differentiating that, you would bring down the power. That, of course, stays following this box system here. You'll take one away from the power, which, of course, is 4, and then you will multiply by the differential of that. So differentiating 4x plus 2, you're going to, of course, get 4. So then you can multiply the 5 times the 4 to get 20. And then, of course, the 4x plus 2 is all to the power of 4. And that is your differential. So let's try another example. Let's say you have the square root of x squared minus 5. So we know already that with something like the square root, the first thing you're going to want to do is be able to rewrite that as a power. So the square root of x squared minus 5 is the same as x squared minus 5 all to the power of 1/2. Okay, so now we realize we have something more complicated than just an x being raised to a power. And this is where your chain rule boxes will come in. And it's a really good tip. As soon as you realize what you're dealing with, for example, that you're dealing with chain rule, a good tip is to draw out your boxes straight away. Okay, and then all you have to do is follow them. All right, so it makes it really easy and a kind of step-by-step process to work through to the answer. So what we have here is x squared minus 5 all to the power of 1/2. So differentiating it will bring down the 1/2. And then, of course, what goes in here is x squared minus 5. Then we take 1 away from that power, so we'll get minus 1/2. And then we'll differentiate this in here. So differentiating x squared minus 5 becomes 2x. And now we just want to tidy this up. That's 1/2 times x squared minus 5 to the power of a minus, remember, will give you a 1 over. And then we have x squared minus 5 to the power of 1/2. And then you have times 2x on the top. Okay. That gives 2x on the top, 2 on the bottom, and of course x squared minus 5 to the power of 1/2 is the same as square root of x squared minus 5. Our 2's will cancel, so we are left with x over the square root of x squared minus 5. Okay, so now we're going to take a look at differentiating trig functions. And of course, when we need to involve the chain rule with the trig functions. So page 25 of the log tables gives us the differentials of our cos, sine and tan. Okay, so we have that nice and straightforward. And that is going to be very easy once you just have an x here. But of course, we know already that as soon as you have something more complicated than just an x, we have got to chain rule it. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do here. So we'll use our box method like before. And in order to chain rule each of these, the minute you have cos and something more complicated than just an x, to chain rule it, it will become, when differentiated, sine of whatever that was minus sine of whatever that was, and then of course times by the differential of whatever that was. Okay, so remember your shaded box is always the differential of whatever this box is or whatever's here. Sine then of something more complicated than just an x will differentiate to cos of whatever that is times the differential of whatever that is. And tan of something more complicated than just an x will differentiate to sec squared of whatever that is times the differential of whatever is in that box. Okay, so let's have a look at some examples. Okay, so let's say you have y equals cos 5x and we want to differentiate it. So again, immediately when you see you have something more complicated than just an x, get your chain rule boxes down so you know exactly what to do. Because once you know the process and you have your boxes down to show you the process, it literally is just filling in each step. So of course, in our box, we have 5x, something more complicated than just the x. So that is going to differentiate to minus sine of that 5x, of course, times by the differential of 5x. And differentiating 5x becomes 5. That then simplifies to minus 5 times sine 5x. Remember, your 5x is an angle. You can't multiply the number to the angle. It is caught up with the sine. You cannot follow normal algebraic rules when you are talking about angles here. Okay, so your final answer is minus 5 sine 5x. Okay, let's try this example. Y equals sine x squared. So again, we realize we have something more complicated than just an x here. So we need to chain rule. So the first thing I'm going to do is put down my chain rule boxes. Sine of something differentiates to cos of that something times the differential of that something. Okay, so in this case, it is of course x squared here. That will differentiate then to cos of x squared. And then we'll times by the differential of what's in that box. Differentiating x squared, of course, is 2x. So that tidies up to 2x cos x squared. Okay, so let's take a look at this example. If you'd like to try it yourself, press pause and see how you get on. This one's a little bit more challenging, but again, we're just going to do it step by step, following our chain rule boxes, and we should be able to get there. So, we realize, of course, straight away, we definitely have something more complicated than just an x here. All right. And also, you should be spotting that the minute you have a root, you know immediately you're going to want to rewrite that as a power. So let's rewrite that function as tan of 2x plus 4 all to the power of 1/2. Okay, so this is what I have. I know I need to chain rule it, so we're going to do our boxes for tan. Tan of something more complicated than just an x differentiates to sec squared of it times the differential of whatever is in there. Okay, so that becomes sec squared, and in here, of course, we get 2x plus 4 all to the power of 1/2 times. Now we need to differentiate this. So here's where I'm going to come over and do a little aside, because the differential of this 2x plus 4 all to the power of a half, this is chain rule as well, okay? So this is what we're working on, the shaded bit here. When you have 2x plus 4 to the power of a half, you need to chain rule it, because we have something more complicated than an x to a power, and that will differentiate to bringing down the power, keeping whatever's in that box here, taking one away, and then times by the differential of whatever is here. In this case, 2x plus 4. So that becomes a half. And then, of course, we have 2x plus 4. Take one away from the power, we get minus a half. And then differentiating what is in here, 2x plus 4 differentiates to 2. I'm just going to tidy this up a little bit more. So I end up with a half. Power of a minus, remember, is 1 over. And then times by 2. And of course, that's going to cancel with that. So now I'm going to put this back in to here, because that's what I've been working on, this differential. So now I've got 6 squared, 2x plus 4 all to the power of a half times by 1 over 2x plus 4 to the power of a half. Okay, and I'll tidy that up too. Of course, this is on the top, 6 squared. 2x plus 4 all to the power of a half is the same as the square root of 2x plus 4. And on the bottom, I have 2x plus 4 to the power of a half, which of course is the same as the square root of 2x plus 4. I'm just going to put brackets around that, because that is of course my angle. And that's your answer.